आदरणीय दर्शकवृन्द, हामी आजको यो विविध सङ्गालो कार्यक्रमको अन्त्यतिर आइपुगेका छौँ। सगरमाथा टेलिभिजन परिवार तपाईँहरूको सहयोग, सल्लाह, सुझाव तथा कार्यक्रमको प्रतिक्रियाको सधैँ अपेक्षा गर्दछ। तसर्थ हाम्रो ठेगाना हो सगरमाथा टेलिभिजन, पिओ बक्स 1400, लुटन, भिर्जिनिया 22079। हामीलाई इमेल गर्न सक्नुहुनेछ। हाम्रो इमेल ठेगाना हो info@nepaltvusa.com। हामीलाई फोन गर्न सक्नुहुनेछ। हाम्रो फोन नम्बर हो 7039269530। त दर्शकवृन्द, अब यहाँहरू समक्ष हाम्रो नेपाली धारावाहिक टेली चलचित्र माइतीको अन्तिम भाग प्रस्तुत गर्दै आजको विविध सङ्गालो कार्यक्रमबाट म विपिनराज उप्रेती बिदा चाहन्छु। आगामी कार्यक्रमसम्मका लागि बिदा दिनुहोस्। नमस्ते।
Now we have a legal discussion with Mr. Fitzgerald Lewis and Mr. Ali Ajar, attorneys at law from the Law Office of Lewis and Associates, Falls Church, Virginia.
Namaste viewers, this is Fitzgerald Lewis
and Ali Ajar
from the Law Offices of Lewis and Associates in Falls Church, Virginia, and you're watching us on Sagarmatha television program. Ali, what are we discussing today?
Mr. Lewis, I wanted to talk a little bit more about our immigration segment that we generally do over here. We've had a series of questions, and off lately we've had questions about 601 waivers and 212 waivers. Could you explain what they are and how does one benefit? I know we've had situations where multiple people from multiple nations, specifically from Bangladesh and in some cases Libya and even Nepal, have questioned us where they have someone who's stuck outside, who needs to come in, and there was some violation committed, but they're not sure how to get over it or overcome that and now try and enter the U.S. Or if there's someone in the U.S. who's facing deportation and has no ties to their home country, how can one bring them back? So if you could please shed some light on that.
Sure. The main issue is a fraud. Now, there are certain things that you cannot get out of. For example, if you tell someone that you are a citizen, and I had a case dealing with a situation where a person took a U.S. passport, this is a long time ago, where there were pictures on the passport. And basically what they ended up doing was they looked like their brother and they came into the United States on a U.S. passport. Mm-hmm. In that case, there is no waiver. There's nothing that can be done if you entered on someone else's U.S. passport because you represented that you are an American citizen. That is just a sin that is unforgivable under the immigration laws. And that's a problem. But in most cases, you are eligible. So let's say that you have committed some kind of fraud other than marriage fraud or asylum is another one, which is a problematic area. But in other cases where you've changed your date of birth, you entered illegally, you did something else. In most cases, if you've committed fraud to gain an immigration benefit, you can apply for a waiver. It's a fairly problematic area. And therefore, you will need to seek counsel, and it's very dependent on the type of fraud that was committed and when it was committed, what time has elapsed. So there are a lot of issues dealing with this. And secondly, you'll have to also show some relationship, meaning you'll have to show extreme hardship on either a United States citizen or a green card holder. And that relationship has to be mother, father, a spouse. So those are the type of things that, as you can see, just explaining this is complicated. Now, the other thing is a lot of times people end up coming over here. I was just talking to a mother today in which she came in and shortly thereafter the husband passed away. And so she became a single parent. She had several children. Two of the boys ended up getting involved with the wrong type of people as they were growing up in the high school system. And they got charged with multiple felonies, multiple misdemeanors. And now what is happening is that even though they got their green cards, they are being deported because of those felonies. Now, in those cases, there are no waivers. So please make sure we as families, we come over here to have a better life. And one of the better lives is not just money, but also take care of your children. Always know where your children are. Because in this case, it was so heart-wrenching because she's a single parent. She was working as a nanny somewhere. And because of that, it was just hard for her to take care of her children. But what ends up happening is the children are going back home and they can't speak the local language. They don't know the customs of their homeland. So all of these are heart-wrenching issues.
Most of the times they don't have any relatives or anybody left in those countries.
And they don't know how to deal with it, just like someone coming from, you know, that part of the world here initially takes a long time to learn the rituals and the customs. It's the same thing is going to be true over there. But the biggest thing is, why did we come over here? To have a better life. And this is not the life we're living. Right. So please ensure that you're not working 80, 90, 100 hours, that both husband and wife are not working. You're putting effort into your children because that's what you're looking for. So please ensure you're doing that, and hopefully you will get the rewards. This is Fitzgerald Lewis
and Eliezer
saying goodbye and God bless for now.
Thank you.
Well, this is all for today. We hope you have enjoyed our program. Now it is time to conclude today's program with this beautiful Nepali song. See you next week. Until then, I'm Sharmila Upreti saying goodbye and namaste. Oh.